This video is weird, creepy, and scary. Okay, Tsunami, thank you for the 3 bits. He said, nah, holding hands is right after marriage. Hugging is 3 years after marriage. Snuggling is 8 years after marriage. And kissing is 10 years. Well, guess what? I don't want to get fucking married. So have you ever kissed someone that turned out more aggressive than you thought it would be? Yes. Well, this one dude, kissed me. And I don't know if it was his first time kissing or if, you know, he just hadn't kissed a lot of people. But he was kissing me so hard that our lips almost bled. I was just like, bro, why are you going in so hard? I was like, ow. Never kissed him again. Weird, creepy, and scary. Okay, let's get into it. Knocking on what?
Gotcha.
All right. We're done. We're fucking done. Hey, we're finished. We're finished. Y'all, my heart is in my ass. Oh my god. Oh my fucking god. I'm not restarting this video. Oh my god. I threw my remote at the TV. Hey, you got me on your TV. I am so sorry. Oh my god. Y'all, it's the fact that I knew it was coming. I didn't know anything was coming. If y'all can hear my heart beating, I got 15 minutes of this shit. If it's a bunch of jump scares, I'm not watching this, y'all. I'm not watching this.
Your ass. Blinking and shit.
What?
Disturb.
What was... You said turn alerts on. You won't. I won't. What is that? This feel like some shit you would see in a flu dream. It's hot. Zia. What the fuck?
Disturbing things found in the forest. In this 2020 footage, the YouTuber Alicia the Explorer is inside a rented cabin in the woods filming a video with his boyfriend. All of a sudden...
See, that's your first mistake. A cabin in the woods? Get out.
Her partner sees something strange passing by the cabin while he's filming Alicia through the window.
Thank you, Tsunami. You said, nah, but all jokes aside, my first kiss felt like a Mission Impossible scene. He tried a whole ass mission trying to kiss at recess without the teacher seeing. We tried hiding in the tunnel slides. Shit was wild, not gonna lie. Oh, y'all was on timing. That's what it was. Y'all was on timing. Ain't no reason why y'all should be hiding in the tunnel slides. Look at y'all. I would've took my belt off and whooped y'all's ass. Okay, but that'd be first kiss. Y'all made it like a little game.
Somebody in there with you? The fuck?
A mysterious figure in robe shows up and walks behind Alicia.
Ew.
But when she looks back, the figure just disappears.
This woman is going back to her apartment and is waiting for the elevator.
Daisy, Daisy.
When she notices this man dressed as a woman, so she goes outside.
Give me your answer. I'm crazy, all for the love of you.
The man waits for her to come back and hides on the stair.
It won't be a stylish marriage. I can't afford
the marriage. Did he turn the lights off?
But you look sweet upon the seat of a bicycle.
Because she's not coming back, he leaves. Yo, that's fucked up. That's some creepy ass shit. Imagine someone waiting for you. What was he gonna do? YouTubers who have gone missing. Don't tell me this. Don't tell me this. Kenny Veach?
Yeah, no.
Any of y'all watch or know of Kenny Veach? You said in Kenny's last video ever, he talks about a hidden cave he found.
I'm looking for a cave that I found, and I didn't have a sidearm when I was here before.
Robbie Flower, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate you.
And something about that cave just spooked me. Out of all the caves I've ever gone in, this one just made my body vibrate. The closer I got to it, the crazier my body felt. And I was like, all right, I'm not going to go in there right now, but I'm coming back someday. So hopefully I'll find it. It's shaped like a big M. It's a big cave that looks just like a gigantic M.
It's shaped just like the letter M. Well, I did not find the cave.
No one believed him. He went looking for it.
That is so weird. I mean, I thought for sure I was just gonna be able to find it.
You have the hole here. You have this piece. It doesn't match this piece or this piece.
Why he look like The Weeknd with no hair? Abel Tesfaye, I'm so sorry, baby. I'm so sorry. But he do. Look at him. Are y'all not, like, y'all don't see it? Y'all don't see it? Hold on, I got you. Just look at him. Look at him. Take a look. You see it clear? That's Abel! That's Abel!
Or this piece. Doesn't
match this piece. Abel, I was so sorry. What the hell? Look just like you.
They're together here.
And I realize I'm finally dating someone whose love language is also physical touch. Don't jump scare me. Don't do it. Stop, stop, stop. Ew! What am I looking at?
Scary stalkers caught on camera.
So like some void meme shit. Sound like some void memes.
2017, Jerome Kennedy heard strange noises coming from the ceiling of his bedroom at night, and suspecting that someone might be up there or in the attic above him, he installed a security camera. The recording shows a man, later recognized by Jerome as his neighbor, crawling around in the attic with a drill and a torch. He then lies on a vent that overlooks Jerome's bed and his daughter's crib and looks at them from—
What?! Yo, okay, so I've seen a video before about people like living in other people's houses without their knowledge. The first thing that comes to mind is that Chris Brown case. Y'all remember Chris Brown has some chick staying at his house and he didn't even know she was there. She was like staying there, like hiding. That's scary. There's this one video on the internet of this guy who kept hearing stuff move around in his house. So he set up cameras and it appears that every other night someone comes from his attic, climbs down, gets shit from his fridge, and goes back up. So he called the cops, and they arrested them. But, like, what the fuck? How do y'all even get up there? Like, what the fuck?
For about 30 minutes.
Do you notice something kind of off about this mannequin? For anyone who's familiar with the legend, she is known as La Pascualita. The mannequin has stood in the window of a Mexican bridal shop for more than 90 years, but when she was first placed there, patrons noticed something kind of strange. The detail work on this mannequin—
Ew, she looks like an animatronic. She looks like half real. She looks like taxidermy.
was unusual. She was noted with eyebrow hair, veins, and even discoloration around her mouth and ears. But that suspicion soon grew to horror as patrons started to notice that she bore a strange...
You said Mexico is fucking haunted as fuck? Really? All cemeteries have haunted shit? Why is Mexico so haunted? What's going on?
Breaking resemblance to the owner's deceased daughter, Pascuela. Pascuela was actually set to be married herself, but ended up dying in a tragedy before her wedding day. Shortly after her death, the mannequin appeared in the window and the legend was born that these were the preserved remains of the owner's daughter. But the most compelling evidence has always been the hands. The hands are shown with wrinkles, they have veins, they even have lifelike fingernails,
taxidermy,
which is unlike any mannequin I have ever seen.
So if you go at night, you'll hear witches laughing, haunted objects will move. So basically, prop hunt at the cemetery. I wanna go. I still wanna go ghost hunting.
The question remains to this day.
Look at her eyes. One eye's looking at me and one eye's looking this way. She's looking left. No, she's looking right. No, she's looking left. Why's she looking like that? Taxidermy.
Ely B, the shop owner's daughter.
You said, I'm gonna be real. I'm African. I still don't believe in that. La bruja? Yes.
Disturbing things caught in churches.
Ew.
In this 2017 footage, the members of a congregation in Peru are happily singing in their church, unaware that something horrifying is about to happen.
I got
During
flies.
The sermon, in fact, the
camera. Ew, they got roaches. They got roaches. Young Chef West 21, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate you.
Camera starts recording some locusts moving around on the wall.
Ew, locusts!
While at first this doesn't look like a real issue, the locusts soon become thousands of thousands.
Oh my god! What? How does it get that bad? How does it? Isn't locusts like a religious thing? Isn't locusts like a large number of locusts in one space like a religious thing? Isn't that in the Bible like something demonic's about to happen? Or like that place is, you get used to it in the hood? Really? No, you don't. I'm not gonna get used to shit.
Happily singing in
that's
the church.
That's nasty.
Unaware
Look,
that something horrifying.
In a church? That's, you said, is that God controlling whatever they wish? A plague.
About to happen. During the sermon, in fact, the camera starts recording some locusts.
What attracts locusts like that though? Like what attracts locusts? Ew.
Moving around on the walls. While at first
church?
This doesn't look like a real issue, the locusts soon become thousands of thousands, invading the whole church and covering every surface.
God.
There were originally three people that got in that ride. But if you notice, the fourth person disappears.
What? Go back.
There were originally three people that got in that ride. But if you notice, the fourth person disappears. When they rewatched the video, they didn't recognize or see anyone next to them. When they noticed
her? The last person died in the roller coaster? Oh, that's Cap. The camera cut off and it only started showing her. She could have been leaning a certain way. Oh, there go Kirby. Kirby, what are y'all doing?
But if you notice, the fourth person disappears. When they rewatched the video, they didn't recognize or see anyone next to them.
Craziest red rum cases caught on camera. The murder of Grace Mullane. Grace Mullane and Jesse Kempson matched on Tinder. This is why I'm not using dating apps. Never have. Never will. Oh, wow. They went on a date before going back to his place. Okay. Damn, multiple cameras caught them, like, together. Last footage of Grace of Live. Oh my god. Are you serious? No way he put her body in that. Oh my god.
idea why. Coming through the kitchen here. Oh, say hi, Bernard.
That's so scary.
He never lets me talk.
Wait, what? He cleaned his car.
No idea why. Coming through the kitchen here. Oh, say hi, Bernard. He never lets me talk. And then I see that.
What is that? What is that? What is that? Are those people? That can't be real. That can't be real. I feel like we're playing Phasmophobia. That can't be real.
This is the third time I've come through.
Why are they just so still? Mm-mm. You guys are coming to clean the room with blood? Yuck. Have y'all been on any dating apps before? Like, what are the dating apps out there? What is it? Tinder? Hinge? Bumble? Facebook Marketplace? What dating apps are y'all on?
And this is exactly how they've seen them. Three times now.
Yubo?
I think I'm going to bed now.
Worst Ways People Have Died, Part 13.
Why do you keep using this song? This song is nasty. Rather be single? Right, I'd rather be single. I'm not getting on any. I would have got the blick. Yeah, I would have. I never can get on dating apps. I don't get it. He said I downloaded Tinder only to swipe, but I never interacted on it, honestly. I downloaded Hinge before, but literally right as I was signing up, I deleted it because they were asking me too many questions. He was digging two big 6-foot holes in the beach. His plan was to connect the tunnels from underneath. What? Wait, he was digging two holes in the sand and he wanted to connect. Oh, baby, he finna die. But he ain't no ant. That's not gonna work. You're right. As you probably understand, that wouldn't go. Yeah, that don't work. It's not funny. That's not funny. But how do you not think about that? How do you not think about that? It's straight gravity. How do you not think about that? The sand started to fall down. He got buried alive into the sand. That's tough. And no one stopped him? Why was he digging? Well, okay, after he connected it, what was he going to do? First of all, how is he going to get up? It's just a lot of stuff that he didn't think about when going into this. And I don't like to make fun of people because it's not right. But at this point, it's just like natural selection. Rest in peace, homie. They tried to get him up out of there. She was alone with her little girl. She didn't see anything until she saw the video.
Lorelei, come here. Lorelei, who are you playing with? What are you doing?
What?
Playing with? Lorelei, come here. Lorelei, who are you playing with? What are you doing?
What? Picture. She didn't see that. She.
Lorelei, come here.
Ew. She playing Phasmophobia in her house.
Lorelei, who are you playing with? What are you doing?
What? Pictures taken before disaster, part 8. So here we have it.
Is that Christina Grimmie? Oh, no. Man, that shit broke my heart. That shit broke my heart when I heard about her passing.
Picture of Christina Grimmie performing at what was her last concert.
Why do I keep playing
after the show ended, there was a meet and greet. And during this meet and greet, this man here approached Christina Grimmie. She approached him with open arms, and he opened fire on her, and she ended up dying. He later took his life.
What? I know about how she passed, but damn. That hurts. Eerie and chilling 911 calls number 3. Ew. September 11, 2001, Kevin Koskov calls 911 from Twin Towers minutes before the first time. Oh, this was 9/11.
I'm on my way to call FC to pick up. What's the telephone number you're calling?
The Grand Street.
It's on 105th floor, the northwest corner, right?
Right. The lady, there's two of us in this office. We're not ready to die, but it's getting bad.
I hate hearing these because I've heard multiple phone calls like during the 9/11 like situation. I've heard multiple as it was happening, and it was very sad.
I want to tell them we can keep the phone call on the apparatus there. I'm trying to let them know where you are.
Let me talk to the caller. Where is he?
He's on the line.
Let me talk to him. Where is the fire, sir? Oh, there's smoke right there. 105 T-Power. All right, sit tight. We'll get to you as soon as we can. Doesn't feel like it, man. I got young kids. I understand that, sir. We're on the way. We're operating.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
Okay, we have everything, sir. You know you do, but it doesn't seem like it. You got lots of people up here.
I understand. My wife thinks I'm all right. I called her and said I was leaving the building. I was fine, and bang. We're looking at the financial center. The three of us, two broken windows.
Oh, God!
That shit is heartbreaking.
Scary moments come.
Why do they do that? Why do they do that? Yeah, that's heartbreaking. Yeah, you know this call? Yeah, there's like a whole video on YouTube of just like 911 calls of people calling from the Twin Towers when that happened. That wasn't scary. That was heartbreaking. That shit was sad. Why the fuck do they keep putting these in the screen?
Caught on Twitch live streams. In this
Twitch live streams?
Live Twitch footage. The streamer Sage Dean experienced a terrible scene in her own house during her live stream. While streaming gameplay to a couple of hundred viewers, a burglar broke into her house and started to look for valuables.
The hell? That's one of my worst fears. That's one of my worst fears. Me going live and some wild shit's happening in my house. Imagine, because they don't know that I got the blicky under my desk.
DB back home.
A few days after the unfortunate incident, the streamer explained to her skeptical...
Oh, she's okay. Oh, thank God. Because that's scary.
...viewers that the robbery was real and it was not scripted for the stream.
When you guys hear that loud bang, that's them coming in with a pointed...
You've probably seen pictures like these online. Places that feel kind of oddly familiar.
I don't know why, but this looked like somewhere I want to go to. This looked like Children's Hospital, the kids section. I'm going to go there.
Or even nostalgic, but also feel uncomfortable. This is the phenomenon of liminal space. Liminal spaces are versions of spaces that we feel
okay,
like we've been
this.
In before.
You got guns? Mm-hmm. I have my gun license, and I own one gun. And a stun gun, and pepper spray, and a few knives. And my entire house, we have weapons strategically placed, so try me, bitch. You said I want to go here and play Call of Duty. Can't get you out of my head. I have a sword. I have a sword. My Uncle Harvey had two swords. And yeah. I got to show it to y'all one day. It's in the garage. But yeah, I have a sword. That shit is nice. You have a carbine? Oh. I got a tank. Okay, I don't have a tank. I don't have a tank. Hey, Department of Weaponry, I don't have one of those. Don't come to my house.
Or that we've seen, but we can't really explain how.
You got a machine, it's so cute, okay? Kind of... I gotta get my stun gun bedazzled. Don't you got mace too? I got three bottles of mace. We like you? I like you. I like you. Or was it just a stun gun? Yes, I have a stun gun. It's pink. I got the Pink Panther stun gun. I gotta get it bedazzled. I want my name on it. I want to say Angel on the back.
Moved through and passing throughout our lives, like hallways and airports or even malls. But it becomes unnerving to see these spaces in a context other than how we know them, where they don't have furniture or they're dimly lit or there aren't people. Many people report that they often feel kind of dreamlike to look at.
This is supposed
almost
to be.
As if they shouldn't exist in this context. It's something that sits in the in-between of what's familiar and what's real, but also something that's not right. It's not entirely understood why these
spaces
evoke feelings
of uneasiness. It's like I feel like I've been to all these
places. Or why we may feel like we've almost been there before. Making
got mace,
the mystery
so I don't
of
have
liminal
to use
space
it.
Just downright.
I've never had to use any of my weapons before, but I will. Every now and then I practice. Every now and then I go outside in like an open field and I just make sure I still got it. Uncle Steve Harvey. His name is not Steve Harvey. His name's just Harvey. Harvey Davis. He be playing the saxophone. He cool.
Very strange.
Disturbing things caught in churches. In
why the chicken? Why the
footage,
chicken?
A man is filming a cathedral at night when something strange grabs his attention. Instead of getting away, the cameraman follows what he's seen, and as he gets closer and closer,
the
face
that.
Begins to slowly pull back behind the wall.
Ew!
The video then makes a quick dash to catch another glimpse, but the face has completely vanished by the time he gets there.
Can I show you a scary
video?
No, because so many of you guys tagged me in this video, and I can see why. It comes from user JR503, and it comes from Veracruz. I'm just gonna tell you, this video is actually like uncomfortable and terrifying to watch. So these men go to a cemetery to explore it, when suddenly they come across this.
Sería bueno que la auto. I can read in Spanish. I swear I can read in Spanish. Autoridad control más esto cementerio. ¿Sí? This is what I'm talking about. Bro, what's going on in the cemetery? This is real? Is this a cult meeting in the cemetery? Is this a cult meeting? They really plan devour out here in the cemetery. They plan devour. What's up? I got the lambs. I'm kidding. Is this brujeria? Is that a bruja? They caught this on camera? They got candles and shit lit over there. There's a dog? Bill's getting lit over there. What's going on? En el sendero del brujo Catemaco, Veracruz. Did I say that right? Sup, Kuya? Sup, Chopstick?
Vamos a salir, vamos.